Hello, my friend. Welcome to TubeU channel. Today, I will show you how to effectively and elegantly use Stable Diffusion. Let's get started. First, you need to install Stable Diffusion WebUI Automatic1111 on your computer. You can refer to my previous video on how to do this. It is easy to follow, even if you have zero knowledge about Stable Diffusion. Additionally, I have provided instruction on where to find a modder that fits your needs, how to download it, and how to use it. You can also compare the difference between browsers that you use for SD WebUI Automatic1111. Once you have correctly launched the SD WebUI, it will look like this. If you do not like this same, you can change it by adding --same-dark to webuiuser.bat and restarting the program.
Or use the default white theme, then type http://127.0.0.1:7860/__theme=dark in the URL place, or change back to white theme by change dark to white.
However, for this tutorial, I will stick with the default white theme. SD WebUI Automatic1111 is a web-based interface that includes several useful tools. We can divide the homepage into several parts. This is the local URL that runs SD WebUI on your computer. Here is where you can select different modders. When you download a new modder and put it into the modder folder, simply click the icon that can refresh the modder list. Sometimes, you may need to restart webuser.bat again. Here is the prompt area where you can input the prompt and control the prompt activity. There are several individual submenus used for different image generation methods. For this tutorial, I will only focus on the text to image menu. There are many methods that you can use to generate beautiful images using good prompt tags. I will make a video discussing these methods in more detail later. Simply talk, in the positive area, the tags will control the SD mostly according to the tag sequence. So usually, I will add the masterpiece and the best quality tag first. In the negative area, the SD will avoid tag elements that you provided, such as disfigured, bad anatomy, deformed, extra limbs, etc. The original Stable Diffusion only supports 75 tokens. Anything longer than that was automatically omitted. However, SD WebUI Automatic1111 has expanded the number to an unlimited amount. You can add as many words as you wish. Making a beautiful figure often requires very precise explanations. This large button serves our primary focus point. By clicking it, the SD Automatic1111 will generate an image based on your prompt and other parameter settings. You also have the option to stop the current process by clicking Interrupt or Skip to the next process if multiple processes are running. The arrow icon is useful for recalling your previous prompts if the prompt area is empty. On the other hand, the trash icon clears all content in the prompt area. The red small icon displays or hides additional networks that can be used for special style modder training. Examples of these include texture invasion, hyper networks, trimbles, and LoRa. I will introduce these in the following video. The checkpoint submenu is helpful for those who are operating like me. It shows all available modders that you can use. Similar to the modder information area, it includes a preview image. By clicking these large icons, the modder area automatically changes to the selected modder. Initially, they may show a non-preview icon, but you can create a typical image using the modder. Hover the mouse icon over the corresponding modder, and it will show a Replace Preview option. By clicking the left mouse button, the current image will display. If nothing is displayed, you can click the refresh button. These features make it easier to select the most suitable model since you have a typical example image as a reference. Once you have selected a model, you can choose the submenu to save space for the parameters area. Additionally, the images are stored in the model's Stable Diffusion folder. The image name is the same as the model name with a PNG extension file name. If you delete the corresponding PNG file and refresh, the previous image will disappear again. Also, you can use your old image as the preview by using the same name as the model. If you fear that the preview is too large, I have found a method to make it smaller. Go to the homepage listed below, copy the code, and paste it into a new text file named user.txt. The file is located in the root folder of SD Automatic1111 WebUI. Change the extension from text to CSS, so user.txt becomes user.css. Finally, restart WebUI user.bat. Now the preview image will be a medium size in the center. These two small icons are useful for saving and reusing your old style simply. For example, in my previous video, I used the same prompt many times. I gave it the name Test Browser and save it as my style. To add it to the prompt area, I clicked this icon and then clicked the Apply button. You can make your own favorite style with this method. For example, I normally add Masterpiece and Best Quality in the prompt area, and add Disfigured, Bad Anatomy, Deformed, and Extra Limbs in the negative area. I saved this as my normal style. When you use a model that is activated with a definite keyword, you can make a special style so you don't need to remember the keyword. For example, use NVInPunk in the prompt to activate the InPunk model, and use MDJRNY-V4 style to activate the OpenGeneral V4 model. These styles can also be used in combination. The whole style file is saved in your Stable Diffusion WebUI folder using the style.csv name. You can edit it using Microsoft Excel or other text editing software. When you open the file, usually the column is too small to show the whole content for every item. You can select them and expand the column with and use the word wrap function. After finish editing, click the refresh button to activate it. Now, move to the parameter area. In the sampling method drop-down list, there are 20 sampling methods available now. The sampling method is the algorithm for the denoising process. At first, Stable Diffusion generates a completely random image in the latent space. The noise predictor estimated the noise of the image, then subtracts the predicted noise from the image to generate a clear image. This process is repeated, and finally, you got a clean image. This process is called sampling because Stable Diffusion generates a new sample image in each step. This method is called a sampling method. They are based on different mathematical models. Some of them are called old-school solvers for ordinary differential equations, ODE. For example, Euler, the simplest possible solver named after Leonhard Euler, whom an improved or modified Euler's method named after Carl Hume, and the linear multiply step method, LMS, same speed as Euler, but more accurate, maybe. You may notice some samplers' name have a single letter A, Euler A, DPM2A, DPM++2SA, and DPM++2SA colors. They are ancestral samplers that add noise to the image at each sampling step. They are stochastic samplers and will not converge. The older samples will converge at high steps. meaning become more and more like after several steps. It is easily distinguished from those two videos using OOLA and OOLA-A sampling method. But it does not mean OOLA is a better method, since we are talking about the art. Our mind should not be fixed on same rulers and frames. Creativity is the most important for the soul of art. DPM, Diffusion Probabilistic Model Solver, is a new sampler designed for diffusion models released in 2022. They present a family of solvers with a similar architecture. DPM2 is a second order, which means it is more accurate but slower. DPM++ is an improvement over DPM. The samplers with the label Keras use the noise schedule recommended in Keras' article. As you can see from this figure, the noise step sizes used by Keras are smaller than normal, and it is said that this improved the quality of images. DDIM and PLMS are the original samplers shipped with the original Stable Diffusion V1. They are optimized and generate good image in just a few steps. UniPC is a new sampler released in 2023 that can achieve high-quality image generation in 5 to 10 steps. Here is a speed test using different sampling methods. So, what is the best sampling method? It is simpler to get a good image using OOLA or Hung with 20 to 30 steps. Avoid using any ancestral samplers if you prefer stable, reproducible images. Use DDIM with about 10 to 15 steps to get a good image. Use UniPC or DMP++2M Keras with 20 to 30 steps to get excellent images. In fact, different sampling methods were suitable for different model, prompt, or other parameters. I will show you how to get the best image using your own method in my following video. Here are the sampling steps. Typically, a large number of the steps will provide a higher quality image, but it will also take more time. Using OOLA sampling method, you can achieve an excellent image with about 15 steps. The width and height define the output image size. Since most models are trained using 512x512, using it as a default can result in better images. Batch count and batch size determine how many images are generated at once. Batch count refers to the number of batches performed, while batch size is the number of images generated in one batch. I tested the speed using OOLA sampling with most default parameters. It took 14.45 seconds to generate a full image using batch count. And 10.51 seconds to generate 4 images using batch size. Batch size uses GPU to generate images simultaneously. When generating multiple images with large size, set batch size to 1 to ensure stable image generation without errors. Stable diffusion may sometimes generate odd images, especially in facial features like eyes and mouth. Turning on Restore Faces can help when the image includes facial elements. To access this feature, go to Setting and select Face Restoration. Choose Code Form or GFP-GAN. Apply the settings and reload the UI. The output image after using face restoration is much better than the original. The tiering function can seamlessly combine images. For example, generate an image with and without tiering using the same prompt and set it as wallpaper. You will see that the original image clearly shows the image boundary, while the tiered image cannot distinguish the border. This high-resolution fix is useful and important when generating high-resolution images. SDV1 uses a 512x512 model, and V2 uses a 768x768 motor, which is too small for many users. After checking the icon, several additional items appear, including list of upscaling methods in the upscale pop-up menu. Use the default latent for the testing. High resolution steps determine the upscale steps after upscaling. Try 20 for testing. Denoising strength can significantly influence image quality. Select 0.6 for the first test. Upscale by is the enlargement factor used, avoiding using large numbers since it may change the image too much. Use 2 as start is a good choice. I will discuss this topic in detail in the following video. CFG scale, classifier-free guidance scale, is a parameter that controls how much the model should respect your prompt. CFG 226 is creative, but it might be too distorted and not follow the prompt. CFG 7-10 is recommended for the most prompts as it strikes a good balance between creativity and guided generation. CFG 10-15 is suitable when your prompt is detailed and very clear on what you want the image to look like. CFG 16-20 is not generally recommended unless the prompt is well detailed, since it might affect coherence and quality. CFG larger than 20 is almost never usable. The seed is a number that determines the initial random noise. Choosing -1 will generate a random image every time. If you select the same seed number, it will generate almost the same image. Click the Reuse Seed button will reuse the last generated seed. The extra checkbox allows you to adjust the seed slightly. The Scrapped drop-down menu contains several advanced functions that will help you use SD more efficiently and elegantly. I will discuss it in the following video. Here is the image output area. The image information will be displayed here once generation is complete. Typically, the image will be automatically saved in the SD outputs folder based on your chosen generation method. If you click the small folder icon, it will open the output directory. The images are organized using the date as the folder name. It is clear that the other tabs function based on their displayed names. At the bottom, there is a system information area. You can click on API to view the API information you used. Clicking on GitHub or Gradia will take you directly to the GitHub or Gradia homepage, respectively. Reload the UI will restart the UI again. Other circumstances are listed here. That's all for today. If you're enjoying my content, please consider subscribing to my channel. Thanks for watching.